We didn't pick HBM for four reasons. The first is it's expensive. It has higher latency than other memory technologies. It lowers yield, and it's impossible for us to get. Okay, yeah, so GDDR sucks. Yeah, we should talk about that. GDDR is a really interesting memory standard. It's a modification of standard DDR memory. It's actually not better though. It's higher latency, it's lower density, and it's also really expensive. This is maybe not commonly known, but GDDR 6, 6X, super expensive. Not as much as HBM, but up there in the range of, I don't want to buy this memory if I'm making a GPU. And so we didn't go with GDDR6 either for that reason. GDDR is also vendor driven, like NVIDIA and AMD work on those specs. It's actually not the other way around. So I don't want to play in that space. I don't care. Why bother? And so we ended up picking DDR5 and LPDDR5X actually because, well, the biggest thing is actually both those memories are really widely available today. Like every PC now has DDR5 DIMMs. Every laptop that has upgradable memory has SO DIMMs. And on the LPDDR5X side, every modern smartphone has LPDDR5X, and there are a billion smartphones shipped a year. A vast majority of them have some form of DDR memory inside of it. So it's very good to be able to kind of slipstream behind the memory vendors and all these, this massive volume in the market today, where I can just readily, literally just go off the shelf, buy the memory I need to build my GPUs.
This is a good example of us doing another kind of inverse design approach where we, instead of looking at, okay, what memory do we have to use to work with this existing architecture, we look at, okay, what memory is the cheapest and most widely available for people to actually use, and then design the actual hardware architecture around that instead.
And it's still better because we control the system design, the chip design itself, the ASIC design, and the software design. We can ensure essentially that everyone is always aware of the design considerations, and that, like I said, we can actually design the chip around LP5X's lower latency, as well as slightly lower bandwidth, but higher efficiency. It makes a massive difference.
Yep.